This is the heart of this cloistered Trappist nun community, gathering for worship and prayer 7 times a day, starting at 3:15 in the morning. And this is the cheese barn, where the 13 sisters at Our Lady of the Angels make 20,000 pounds of Gouda every year. Most of their $250,000 business is mail order, although some local shops drive out monthly for the cheese their customers crave.
The flavor's great. It's on the mild end in terms of, you know, intensity, but it's delicious and you know, really versatile. You can use it for cooking, or you can just nosh it with salami and olives and bread.
When they started, the nuns knew nothing about how to make cheese. Today, they literally cannot keep up with the demand from food connoisseurs around the country.
It sort of sells itself. People get it as a gift. And they call and they say, could I order some of this cheese?
Sister Barbara is one of the original 6 who was sent by a large monastery in Massachusetts to start anew on this gorgeous piece of land near Charlottesville, Virginia. The goal, followed the centuries-old rules of St. Benedict by building a life based on prayer and engage in manual labor to support themselves. Happily for the sisters, the property they bought already featured a cheese-making facility.
We were so naive, we thought it'd be so simple. You have some of this equipment here, and you just get some milk and a few lessons and just make some cheese.
But the sisters persevered, and they got it right, really right. They allot 32 days a year to make the Gouda, and everyone pitches in. Sister Maria is the designated cheese cook. The 35-year-old from Spain must manipulate some 6,000 pounds of pasteurized milk with a little culture and rennet into several hundred wheels of cheese. It looks easy, but like any good recipe, it's all about precision, getting the correct temperature, cutting the curds at just the right moment, heating them, then draining the whey, and finally pressing the cheese. Over the years, the sisters have not only perfected their technique, they've never bungled a batch. That's almost unheard of. Sister Linda is sidelined from the cheese making with an injury right now, but says her fellow sisters' attention to detail is key.
A big part of it has been their openness to learning and their absolute dedication to it. Doing it better.
The sisters say prayer is also a big part of their work, from making the cheese to shipping it out.
While I'm doing it, I'm really praying for the people who are gonna eat that cheese. I mean, I know every family, every person have problems.
For every 5 cheese orders that come in the mail, at least one, maybe out of every 4, one will have a request for prayers.
Prayer is also the reason the nuns say they won't grow their business.
People will come in and say, well, you sold out last year, so you're going to make more next year, aren't you?
The priority is not the cheese. That's not why we're here.
What is happening here? A seeking after the Lord that is visibly discernible.
It's fun to see the nuns, and they're so, you know, kind and calm and mellow. It sort of slows you down a little bit.
People come to the door, come to buy cheese. We always tell, they always want to know a little bit about our way of life, so we tell them. And then we ask them if they'd like to stop in the chapel for a moment.
When they're not in the chapel or making the cheese, the nuns do admit to eating it often. And there is a preferred method.
My favorite way to have it is on a piece of toast for breakfast.
If you toast a piece of bread so that the bread is kind of crispy, and then you put a couple thin slices of cheese on, put it in the microwave for 25 seconds.
So what's next for the sisters? No cheddar or Havarti, they say. It's strictly Gouda. As for their numbers, it's clear a new generation is needed sometime soon. But these women believe if they remain true to their calling, God will replenish their ranks in His time.
We are here together because God called us here one way or another. We all followed what we perceived to be God's call to us individually. We never knew each other before, you know, so it's not a coincidence, but part of a larger plan that remains a mystery.
It is a beautiful, holy mystery that's unfolding here as the sisters seek out God and find ways to minister through simple 2-pound wheels of cheese. Reporting in Crozet, Virginia, Heather Sells, CBN News.